welcome to those of you who arrived later. My name is King Ji. I'm the Associate Administrator for Infrastructure with Federal Highways. I am with the Federal Highway Administration. What you will see behind me are illustrations of what highway engineers, both bridge, pavements, and all kinds of other highway-related engineers are involved in. An effective, efficient, and safe highway system is critical to the mobility of our citizens and key to U.S. economic vitality. We depend on our roads and highways every day to deliver goods and services as a commuter network and as a connection to our friends, family, and leisure activities. As the chief steward of our nation's highway program, the Federal Highway Administration is accountable to Congress and to our citizens to provide for our highway system. FHWA, which is our acronym, alone does not directly deliver the nation's highway program. Our success is dependent directly on a network of public and private organizations operating in a variety of disciplines, including consulting engineering, construction engineering, maintenance, environment, planning, safety, finance, and many others. Two of our key partners, the American Council of Engineering Companies and the American Society of Civil Engineers, are participating here with us today. FHWA has a division office in every state that together with the State Departments of Transportation, the more than 39,000 local agencies and other local agencies with road management responsibilities, along with our public and private sector partners, design, deliver, and manage the nation's highways program. There are 4 million road miles and over 600,000 bridges that make up the highway system in the United States. And this highway system ranges in size from our interstate highway system to arterial roads that consist of limited access freeways to multi-lane roads that connect major urban areas all the way down to local and rural roads that provide access to less populated areas. Surprising to some is that of the more than 4 million U.S. road miles, the interstate system accounts for just 1%. And that 1% carries 25% of all the traffic in this country. And yet, it is the interstate system that is the most recognized of all the U.S. roadways. And it is because of its heavy use. The interstate highway system was a vision of President Dwight D. Eisenhower. Drawing from his military experience as commander of the Allied forces in Europe during World War II, then General Eisenhower recognized the value of effective transportation. As president, he wanted to realize his vision of a highway network for the United States that would provide for greater mobility for our citizens and, if needed, transportation for troops and military equipment. On June 29, 1956, then President Eisenhower signed the Federal Aid Highway Act of 1956 into law, and that law provided for funding of the interstate system and authorized construction. There have been a lot of changes in the highway network since the beginning of the interstate highway system in the late 1950s. Much of that same interstate highway infrastructure and many of the primary and secondary roadways that support the interstate system now need repair. At the same time, we are challenged as a nation to provide the resources necessary to make much of the needed repairs and other improvements that are enhancing to the system. We have not kept pace with the improvements needed to meet today's transportation needs. By 2050, the United States will be home to 100 million additional people, the equivalent of another California, Texas, New York, and Florida combined. Potentially, our next generation of entrepreneurs may find America's arteries of commerce seriously compromised, and our families and neighbors will endure even greater congestion. President Obama, in his State of the Union address in January, set as his priorities education, innovation, and infrastructure. Rebuilding America's roads and bridges will expand access to jobs, education, and health care in the short term, and lay the foundation of our nation's future economic growth in the long term. As a transportation community, we want to be efficient and effective with the resources that we have, and we are working with our public and private sector partners to do just that. We are working hard to identify and implement new technologies and processes that will continue to make us more efficient in how we plan, deliver, and manage the nation's highway program. Moving innovation to application through a skilled, technically competent workforce is critical to the success of our nation's transportation program. A career in transportation can be very rewarding. And like Mrs. Stone, I have spent 35 years of my life dedicated to this profession. We face a number of challenges, however, in transportation today, and there will be even greater challenges in the future as the demand for transportation increases and the U.S. operates in an increasingly competitive global economy. A skilled, technically competent workforce will provide for our greatest return on investment and will be our best asset in efforts to reduce the gap between available resources and growing transportation needs. I am proud of the work we are doing in federal highways. We are working to mobilize the highway transportation industry to move innovation to application through our new Everyday Counts initiative, EDC, Everyday Counts. EDC is an initiative that proactively requires a commitment and effort by our public and private partners to do two things: shorten the time it takes to deliver projects and to quickly implement new technologies that benefit our highway system. And on the technology side, we have five technologies that we're pushing pretty hard right now. The first is adaptive signal control technology. I'm going to run through these very quickly so that you get a sense of what we're involved in that you can aspire to. So the first of the five is adaptive signal control technology. How many times have you been stuck at a red light and there's no traffic on the cross street? Well, with this adaptive signal control, it senses whether there's traffic on a side street waiting to enter the intersection or not. If not, it will not give a green to that side street. And as amazing as may sound, we don't have that throughout this country today. A second technology is geosynthetic reinforced soil integrated bridge systems. That may sound like a long title, but basically it's a simple way of using granular fill or soil and gravel along with geosynthetic fabrics to rapidly construct a foundation on which the bridge can be built. So instead of talking about a matter of months or years to get a bridge built, we're talking about a matter of weeks. The third technology is prefabricated bridge elements and systems. And this allows an old bridge to be replaced quickly, sometimes overnight. And what you see here is a move I actually watched, where they built the replacement bridge off-site. In one weekend, they shut down the freeway. This is in Utah, Salt Lake City, Utah. In one weekend, they shut down the interstate, which is six lanes. And on Saturday, jacked the old bridge up out of its foundation, moved it off-site for demolition, finished preparing the foundation, and on Sunday, as you see in these two slides, moved the replacement bridge into place. One weekend closure, the overpass was replaced, and a roadway that went over the interstate was only closed for 10 days. That's the kind of challenges that we're facing in our urban areas to rapidly replace an aging infrastructure. A fourth technology is a safety edge. Many of you have been going through work zones. You see oftentimes work can't be completed in a day or a week. And oftentimes when paving happens, they leave an edge that cars can kind of drop down. And to come back onto the roadway often is pretty hard, and sometimes it causes accidents. With the safety edge technology, we create a 45-degree angle at the edge of pavement during the construction phase so that if a car does go off, it can recover safely and efficiently, effectively. And finally, Mr. Stone talked about sustainability. Asphalt, which is a key part of our paving of roads, is heated up pretty hot. With warm mix asphalt, we're talking about a much lower temperature that the asphalt can be produced at, and so it reduces the greenhouse gas emissions. It also allows us to do paving in a much cooler climate. So these five technologies are really technologies that advance cost savings but shorten construction time. So at the Federal Highway Administration, we recognize that EDC is not just about innovation. It's also about balancing the need for leadership to push new technology and innovative processes with the flexibilities that states and local agencies need in order to fulfill their jobs. So the state and local agencies are in the best positions to decide which technologies they need to use and how to employ them. And we also recognize that EDC is about taking ownership of the principles and the goals of the initiative, about a level of commitment to make things better, about owning the idea that we can do better and we can deliver projects sooner, and working together, we can get benefits of new technologies to the users quicker. So we do want to create a culture of innovation in transportation that is open to new ideas and new ways of doing things. Our focus on innovation through our EDC program will make transportation better and certainly supports President Obama's priorities of education, innovation, and infrastructure. Engineers have been the drivers for our highway program since before the interstate era. They were central to the success of the interstate system and a catalyst of our Everyday Counts initiative. Engineers will continue to be key contributors to our highway program now and for the future. Engineers do move America. Thank you, and best wishes in your career and safe travels on our highways.